It didn't look like much, just an island in a dry riverbed with a tree, a few rocks, and a patch of wheat. If you walked by, you probably wouldn't even notice it. But if you stopped and took a close look, you'd see ants everywhere, scurrying, climbing, plucking, carrying, working all day long in the blazing sun. They called the place Ant Island, and it was bursting with life, a bug's life. The ants were harvesting wheat, piling the grains on a large altar by the anthill. Nervously supervising the workers was Princess Atta, who was training to be the next queen of the ant colony. Her mother, the queen, looked on.
Okay, Atta, now what do we do?
Oh, don't tell me. I know it. What is it?
We relax.
Right.
Oh, it'll be fine. It's the same year after year. They come, they eat, they leave. That's our lot in life. It's not a lot, but it's our life.
Just then, two ant boys went racing past, followed by a little ant girl. She was Princess Dot, Atta's younger sister. Dot tried to fly after the boys, but her tiny wings didn't work, and she tumbled to the ground.
Dot!
Yes, Mother?
What did I tell you about trying to fly?
Not until my wings grow in.
Right.
As they spoke, a shadow fell across them.
Look out!
Before they could move, a stalk of wheat came flying through the air, burying Atta. The Council of Elders who were working nearby came hurrying over. There was Thorny, the chief engineer, Cornelius, Minister of Agriculture, Mr. Soil, Minister of Education, and Dr. Flora, head of the health department.
Atta!
Princess Atta!
Princess Atta!
Emerging from a patch of wheat came an ant named Flick. Like the other ants, he was harvesting, but in a very different way. Flick was an inventor, and he was wearing his latest invention, a strange-looking harvester made of twigs and reeds. It would cut down the wheat, shake the grain into a basket, and throw away the stalk. As the council hovered around, another stalk came flying from the harvester, nearly hitting them.
Oh! Look out!
Stop that!
What do you think you're doing?
You could have killed somebody over here!
Hearing them, Flick looked up and realized what he had done.
I'm sorry, sir. Please forgive me. I'm sorry.
He helped the council members lift the stalk, and Atta came crawling out.
Princess Atta!
Flick, what are you doing?
Oh, this! This is my new idea for harvesting grain. No more picking individual kernels. You can just cut down the entire stalk.
Flick tried to demonstrate. Instead, he spilled grain everywhere. Atta shook her head in disgust.
Please, Flick, just go.
As Flick trudged back to work, Dot called after him.
Hey, Flick! Flick, wait up!
Oh, hello, Princess.
I like your inventions.
Really? Well, you're the first. I'm beginning to think nothing I do works.
This works?
Great. One success. I'm never gonna make a difference.
Me neither. I'm a royal ant and I can't even fly yet. I'm too little.
Oh, being little's not such a bad thing.
Here. Pretend
that that's a seed. Now, do you see our tree? Everything that made that giant tree is already contained inside this tiny little seed. Now, you might not feel like you can do much now, but that's just because, well, you're not a tree yet. You just have to give yourself some time. You're still a seed.
You're weird, but I like you.
Suddenly, an alarm sounded, and Flick looked up at the sky.
They're here.
Overhead, a swarm of grasshoppers appeared on the horizon, buzzing ominously. The queen let out a loud whistle.
Okay, everyone, single file. Food to the offering stone and into the anthill. Now let's go!
The ants lined up quickly, placing their grain on the altar, then disappearing into the anthill. Atta helped the last worker inside, or so she thought. A moment later, Flick staggered out of the wheat patch, tangled up in his harvester, and found that he was alone.
Hey! Hey, wait for me!
He managed to free himself, but as he did, a spring popped loose from the harvester, knocking the legs out from under one side of the altar.
No! Oh!
As he watched in horror, the altar tipped sideways and the huge pile of grain spilled over the edge of the island, disappearing into a puddle below.
Oh, no.
Princess Anna! Princess Anna! Princess Anna!
Flick dove into the anthill. As he did, the buzzing of the grasshoppers grew louder. Then it stopped, and the ants heard voices outside.
Hey, what's going on?
Yeah, where's the food?
Inside the anthill, Ada stared at Flick.
What did you do?
It was an accident.
A nasty-looking foot punched a hole in the ground above them, letting in a shaft of light. More holes were punched, and the grasshoppers dropped through into the heart of the anthill. Their leader, a giant armored creature with a scar running through one eye, landed right in front of Flick.
Hopper.
Hopper pushed his way past Flick and confronted Ada.
So where is it?
Where's my food?
Isn't it up there?
What?
Why am I even talking to you? You're not the queen. You don't smell like the queen.
She's learning to take over from me, Hopper.
Oh, I see. Under new management.
Hopper crouched down beside Ada for a talk. His brother Malt stood by, ready to chime in.
It's a bug-eat-bug world out there,
Princess. Now let me tell you how things are supposed to work. The sun grows the food, the ants pick the food, the grasshoppers eat the food.
And the birds eat the grasshoppers. Hey, like the one that nearly ate you? You remember? Oh, you should have seen it, okay?
Malt.
This blue jay, he has him halfway down his throat, okay? And
Hopper picked up his brother and pushed him against the wall.
Oh, come on! It's a great story! Ow.
I swear, if I hadn't promised Mother on her deathbed that I wouldn't kill you, I would kill you!
And believe me, no one appreciates that more than I do.
Hopper straightened up and faced the ants once again.
Hey, I'm a compassionate insect. There's still a few months till the rains come, so you can all just try again.
But Hopper, it's almost the rainy season. We need this time to gather food for ourselves.
Listen, if you don't keep your end of the bargain, then I can't guarantee your safety, and there are insects out there that will take advantage of you.
Someone could get hurt.
Hopper stepped aside to reveal Thumper, a snarling grasshopper who clawed the ground and strained at his leash, eyeing the ants hungrily. Dot, who was terrified, turned to run and bumped right into Hopper. He picked her up and dangled her in the air.
What's the matter? You scared of grasshoppers?
Leave her alone!
You want her? Go ahead. Take her. No? Then get back in line.
He let Dot go, and she scrambled to hide behind the queen. Smiling grimly, Hopper turned to the others.
It seems to me that you ants are forgetting your place.
So let's double the order of food.
No, but...
We'll be back at the end of the season when the last leaf falls. You ants have a nice summer.
Let's ride!
The next day, Flick was brought before the Queen, Princess Ada, and the Council of Elders.
Flick, what do you have to say for yourself?
Sorry. I'm sorry for the way I am. I didn't mean for things to go so wrong. I especially didn't want to make you look bad, Princess.
Well, Flick, you did.
I was just trying to help. Help. Helpers to help us. That's it. That's the meal leave. Sure, you can go find helpers to help us.
It's perfect!
Perfect? What's so perfect?
Your Highness, don't you see? We could send someone to get help.
Leave the island?
Now, why didn't I think of that? Oh, because it's suicide.
I'll volunteer. I'd be very happy to volunteer.
You got a lot of spunk, kid, but no one's gonna help a bunch of ants.
At least we could try. Oh, I could travel to the city. I could search there.
If you went, you'd be on that silly search for weeks.
Hearing that, the Council of Elders perked up. They pulled Ada aside and reminded her how nice it would be to have Flick out of their hair for a while. By the time they finished, Ada had made up her mind.
Flick, after much deliberation, I have decided to grant you your request.
Really?
Really?
Really.
Oh, thank you, Princess. Thank you so much for this chance. I won't let you down. I promise I won't screw up. I promise.
Far away, in the city, P.T. Flea and his bug circus were putting on a show. A ferocious-looking beetle named Dim was in the center ring, held at bay by Rosie, a black widow spider and wild bug trainer.
Back! Get back! Back, you horrible beast! I have no fear! Hi-ya!
Rosie cracked her whip, which was actually a shoelace, and it brushed against Dim's paw.
Oh, my goodness!
He stopped suddenly, his lower lip trembling. Dim toppled onto his back and burst into tears.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm so sorry, Dim. An owie? Oh, okay, show Rosie the owie. All right, Dim, it's okay.
In the stands, a family of flies got up to leave.
Ugh, I have been in outhouses that didn't stink that bad. This is ridiculous. What a disappointment.
P.T. Flea, seeing them go, turned to his clowns, Heimlich, Slim, and Francis.
We're losing the audience! You clowns, get out there now!
Heimlich, a chubby caterpillar, stopped to complain.
I hate performing on an empty stomach.
Do your act, Heimlich, then you can eat.
Slim, a walking stick, shook his head sadly.
What's the point of going out there? They'll only laugh at me.
That's because you're a clown!
The third clown, Francis the Ladybug, wasn't a lady at all. He was a guy, and he wanted to make sure everyone knew it, including a group of rowdy flies who shouted to him from the front row.
Hey, cutie! Want to pollinate with a real bug?
Francis fluttered up to them, smiling demurely, then bellowed at the top of his lungs.
So, being a ladybug automatically makes me a girl. Is that it, Flyboy? Huh?
Cripes! She's a guy!
P.T. Flea, afraid things were getting out of hand, hopped into the center ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present Mantle the Magnificent and his lovely assistant, Gypsy!
Manto, an aging magician known to his friends as Manny, stepped into the spotlight. He was a praying mantis, and his assistant, who was also his wife, was a gypsy moth. Swirling his cape, Manny nodded to Gypsy, and she lowered herself into a box.
From the most mysterious regions of uncharted Asia, I give you the Chinese Cabinet of Metamorphosis. I summon the voice of Confucius.
Get off the stage, you old hack!
I demand to know who said that.
A piece of food landed in Manny's face with a splash.
How dare you! Ingrates!
The flies started to leave, and Manny stalked off stage, leaving Gypsy stuck in the box.
Manny?
P.T. Flea, desperate to lure the crowd back, grabbed a matchstick and leaped back into the center ring. He struck the match and set it blazing.
Flaming dead! I hold in my hand the match! The match that decides whether two bugs live or die this very evening.
Curious, some of the flies stopped to watch and listen.
In a moment, I will light this trail of matches leading to a sheet of flypaper. Doused in lighter fluid! Aim directly at the flypaper, our tuck and roll! The pillbug cannonballs! Our pillbug's only hope of survival is our mistress of the high wire, Rosie! Secured to a web line of exact length, Rosie will plummet down to these two posts, spinning a web of safety in less than 15 seconds! Not good enough, you say. Well, what if they were all blindfolded?
As the lights were lowered, Tuck and Roll lost control and bumped into P.T. Flea. P.T. dropped his match, accidentally lighting the trail of matches before everyone was ready.
No!
High up on the center pole, Rosie cocked her ear.
Go! Oh, okay.
She began to spin a web as fast as she could. But since she'd been taken by surprise, the web was lopsided and had a hole in the center. Meanwhile, the cannon went off, rocketing Tuck's brother, Roll, straight into P.T. Flea. P.T. was launched through the hole in the web and onto the flypaper, where he stuck tight. Heimlich, Francis, and Slim watched in horror as the wall of fire advanced toward the flypaper.
Water! We need some water!
Water, 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 water!
Get me out of here!
But it was too late. The flypaper went up in flames, burning P.T. to a pathetic cinder.
You're all fired.
Huh? We got the water. We'll save you.
That evening, in a nearby saloon, the circus bug sipped on drops of colored liquid, trying to make sense of it all. Slim, Francis, and Heimlich couldn't believe what had happened.
Fired by a flea. How humiliating.
Let's face it, we stink.
Someday, I will be a beautiful butterfly, and then everything will be better.
As they spoke, a group of bugs approached. It was the rowdy flies from the circus.
All right, clown, get up and fight like a girl.
Francis, hoping to head off trouble, signaled Slim and Heimlich to begin one of their clown routines based on the story of Robin Hood. Heimlich drew a sharp toothpick from a nearby olive while Francis picked up Slim and swung him like a sword.
Stand back, ye flies! We are the greatest warriors in all bugdom!
The flies weren't impressed. They just kept coming.
Methinketh it's not working!
Back to Sherwood Forest! Snell, snell!
The circus bugs retreated up the wall, followed by the flies, followed by a curious group of bystanders. The saloon, which was actually an empty paint can, began to tip over with their weight. It rocked out of its foundation and rolled down the street like a runaway train. A moment later, it crashed to a stop, with the circus bugs perched on top and flies lying unconscious all around them. The entire town saw what had happened, including a newcomer who had just arrived from Ant Island. It was Flick.
You're perfect! Great ones! I have been scouting for bugs with your exact talents!
A talent scout?
My colony is in trouble! Grasshoppers are coming! We've been forced to prepare all this food!
Dinner theater!
Food? Please! Will you help us?
Just then, Slim noticed some of the flies waking up.
We'll take the job!
Really?
Yes, yes, yes! You can explain the details on the way.
Slim picked up Flick and plopped him onto Dim's broad back. Then the circus bugs took off into the night sky.
Amazing! This is too good to be true!
When they arrived on Ant Island the next day, Atta and the other ants gathered around, surprised to see Flick back so soon.
He's back? What? How? He wasn't supposed to actually find someone.
Francis, nervous that he and his friends might lose the job, tried to assure Atta that they would put on a great show.
Your Majesty, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, our troop here guarantees a performance like no other. Why, when your grasshopper friends get here, we are gonna knock them down. Dead!
Later that day, the ants held a banquet for their guests. Dot and some of her school friends presented them with a special gift. It was a mural, which showed a fierce battle between the grasshoppers and the bugs. Rosie looked it over.
Oh, look at the beautiful colors of the blood.
We drew one of you dying because our teacher said it would be more dramatic.
That was when the circus bugs finally figured it out. They weren't going to put on a show. They'd been hired to fight. They stared at the mural in shock as Flick got up to make a speech.
Now, I know that I've made a lot of mistakes in the past, and I hope that this will make
Flick.
Up...
Not right now, Rosie. I'm making a speech.
Ugh. Now, I truly believe that these bugs are the answer to our...
No, there's no circus around here.
So, I'm
Flick gaped at Rosie. Finally, he understood the terrible mistake he had made. Flick excused himself, then stumbled away from the banquet table and faced the bugs.
Circus bugs! How can you be circus bugs?
What?
Excuse me. Oh, hey. You said nothing about killing grasshoppers, pal. You lied to us.
Yeah!
Are you kidding? Do you know what this is? This, my friends, is false advertising.
How dare you? You, sir, are the charlatan in this scenario, touting your wares as a talent scout, preying upon the hungry souls of hapless artists. Good day to you, sir.
As the bugs moved off, Flick flung himself at Slim, latching onto his foot.
No, you can't go! I'm desperate!
Really? I couldn't tell!
The bugs left Ant Island and crossed the dry riverbed, with Flick hanging on to Slim for dear life. Then, without warning, he let go.
Ah! Run!
Flick saw what the bugs hadn't noticed. They were approaching a bird's nest, and a massive sparrow loomed in the air above them. The bugs raced off after Flick, with the bird flying right behind. It dove at them, narrowly missing, then circled around for another try. Suddenly, a cry rang out from above them. It was Dot. Hoping to get a glimpse of Flick's meeting with the bugs, she had grabbed a dandelion puff and floated up into the sky. It had been an exciting trip, until the sparrow saw her.
Flick!
The sparrow rocketed straight toward her. Dot had no choice but to let go. The bird missed by inches, but now Dot was plummeting toward the ground. Francis, hovering in the air below her, looked up.
Huh? I got you! I got you!
Francis caught her, but the force of her fall knocked them backward into a narrow gorge. When Dot glanced around, she saw that Francis was unconscious and his leg was pinned beneath a large rock.
Please, ma'am, wake up! Wake up!
Meanwhile, the bird landed and began pecking at the gorge. Just as it was about to reach Dot and Francis, a voice rang out.
Yoo-hoo! Mr. Early Bird! How about a nice tasty worm on a stick?
The bird looked around. On the far side of the riverbed stood Slim, holding Heimlich up over his head. As the bird started toward them, Flick and the other circus bugs hurried to the gorge.
There they are!
Flick, help!
It's going to be okay, Dot.
Rosie lowered Flick, Tuck, and Roll into the gorge, using a net she had made from her webbing. They loaded Dot and Francis onto the net with them, and Flick gave a thumbs-up signal. Dim, flying nearby, lifted all of them out of the gorge and into the sky. But they weren't out of trouble yet. Francis came too, accidentally knocking Flick and Dot to the ground, right in front of the bird. As the bird moved toward them, Flick scooped up Dot and ran as fast as he could. He tried to leap over a deep crack, but it was too wide, and they started to fall. Suddenly, they found themselves flying through the air upside down. Looking up, Flick saw Dim flying above him, with Tuck and Roll hanging below like a trapeze act. The two pill bugs had grabbed Flick by his feet, pulling Flick and Dot to safety. As they landed, Rosie noticed a sound and turned to Manny.
What is that?
That, my friends, is the sound of applause!
The bugs turned around, and there were the Queen, Princess Atta, the Council, and a crowd of cheering ants. They had seen the whole thing. The circus bugs were heroes. Later, at the ant hospital, Francis lay in bed with a broken leg. Dot and her friends, a troop of blueberry scouts, were gathered around the bed, along with Atta and Flick.
Our blueberry troop salutes you bugs for rescuing our smallest member, Princess Dot. We voted you our honorary dead mother.
Yay!
What? Great.
Atta smiled, then pulled Flick aside.
Say, Flick, I think you're ready for a promotion. How would you like to be the Queen's official aide to the warrior bugs?
Me? No.
Well, not every bug would face a bird. I mean, even Hopper's afraid of them.
Yeah, well, I guess, you know, maybe I have... Say that again?
I said, even Hopper's afraid of birds.
Flick turned and hurried off, leaving Atta staring after him. He went straight to the circus bugs.
Oh, this is perfect. We can get rid of Hopper, and no one has to know that I screwed up. You just keep pretending you're warriors.
Whoa, Flick, honey. We are not about to fight grasshoppers, okay?
You'll be gone before the grasshoppers ever arrive. It'll be easy. Here's what we do.
Not another word. I don't know what you're concocting in that little ant brain of yours, but we'll have no part of it.
Just then, someone tugged at Manny's sleeve. It was a couple of ant boys.
Excuse me? Could we get the warriors' autographs?
Autographs? Yeah!
There you go, my boy.
Wow, thanks! When I grow up, I'm gonna be a praying mantis.
I'm gonna be a stick bug.
Oh, they're all so cool. I can't pick!
As the boys left, Manny and the others beamed. They were stars, just as they'd always hoped to be. As Flick studied their faces, suddenly he knew the circus bugs would help. Flick explained his plan, and Manny listened carefully so that the next day he could present it to the council word for word.
All right, we are going to build a bird. A bird that we can operate from the inside, which would then
be hoisted above the anthill and hidden high in the tree. Then, right when Hopper and his gang are below, we launch the bird and scare off the grasshoppers.
The council, eager to support Flick and his warrior friends, agreed to the plan. Soon, the entire colony was hard at work on the project. They finished the bird a week later, stored it in the tree, and held a banquet to celebrate. During the festivities, Atta found Flick sitting with the bugs.
Will you look at this colony? Will you just look at this colony? I don't even recognize them. And I have you bugs to thank for it, so thank you. And thank you for finding him, Flick.
Me?
Atta leaned toward him, and somehow their antennas got tangled.
Huh? Oops. I'll get it. If you don't mind, I'll just.
It's all tangled up.
There.
Wow. I think I'll go check on the bird.
Atta started off, then came back, blushing.
Bird's this way.
Suddenly, the alarm went off, and Atta yelled over the crowd.
Battle stations, everyone! This is not a drill! Come on, everyone! You know your jobs! Let's go, 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 go!
As the ants scrambled for cover, a familiar-looking wagon barreled into the clearing, led by a team of millipedes and driven by P.T. Flea.
Whoa, whoa, whoa there! Steady, girls! That's it!
It's P.T.
P.T.
The bugs tried to hide, but P.T. saw them.
Ah, guys, I've been looking all over for you.
No.
Flaming Death is a huge hit.
P.T.,
I'm serious. Word of mouth got around.
No.
The next day, there was a line of flies outside the tent. Went on forever. It must have been a foot long.
P.T.,
So, I figured it out. You guys burn me twice a night. I take a day off to heal. And then we do it all over again. We'll be the top circus act in the business.
Atta stared at the bugs.
You mean you're not warriors?
Are you kidding? These guys are the lousiest circus bugs you've ever seen. And they're gonna make me rich!
Tell me this isn't true.
No, you don't...
The queen glared at Flick.
We're going to hide all this and pretend it never happened. You bugs were never here, so I suggest you all leave.
Oh, but the bird! The bird will work!
I never thought I'd see the day when an ant would put himself before the rest of his colony.
What?
You lied, Flick. You lied to her. You lied to the colony. You lied to me. And like an idiot, I believed you.
I just wanted to make a difference.
I want you to leave, Flick. And this time, don't come back.
Heartbroken, Flick followed the bugs to the circus wagon, where P.T. was waiting.
Tough crowd.
Yeehaw!
The wagon moved off slowly, with Flick and the circus bugs trudging along behind. Later that day, the last leaf fell, and, true to their word, the grasshoppers returned. Hopper stood at the altar, staring at the meager pile of grain.
Have you been playing all summer? You think this is a game? Well, guess what? You just lost. Not one ant sleeps until we get every scrap of food on this island!
Hopper motioned, and the grasshoppers herded the ants into the fields, but not all the ants were there. High atop a boulder sat Dot and her troop of blueberry scouts watching the scene below.
Quick, to the clubhouse!
As the blueberries filed into their clubhouse, they heard a voice outside. It was one of the grasshoppers.
Didn't you hear, Hopper? After the ants pick all the food, he's gonna squish the queen to remind them who's boss. Then she's dead. They cry, boo-hoo, we go home, end of story.
Oh, cool.
Dot turned to her friends, horrified.
Stay here, I'm gonna get help.
She sneaked out of the clubhouse, then raced off. Rounding a corner, she ran right into Thumper. Petrified, Dot took off in the other direction and found herself at the edge of a steep cliff. Behind her, Thumper charged, forcing her over the edge. Dot tumbled down, down, and then, as if in a dream, she was rising in the air, flying. At the last possible minute, Dot's wings had grown in. She checked to make sure Thumper was gone, then turned away from Ant Island and went off in search of help. Flick and the others had just crossed the riverbed when Dot caught up with them.
Dot, you're flying. What are you doing here?
Hopper moved into the anthill and his gang's eating everything. And I heard a grasshopper say that when they're finished, Hopper's gonna squish my mom.
Oh, how awful.
The queen.
Well, we gotta do something.
How?
Come on, you guys, think.
Oh, I know, the bird.
Yes, of course. The bird, that's brilliant. Yeah.
The bird won't work.
But you said that everything...
Forget everything I ever told you, all right, Dot? Let's face it, the colony is right. I just make things worse. That bird is a guaranteed failure. Just like me.
Flick, please?
She picked up a small stone and set it down beside him.
Pretend it's a seed, okay?
Flick gazed at the stone. Little by little, he began to smile.
Thanks, Dot. All right, let's do it.
They locked P.T. Flea in the wagon, then turned it around and headed back to Ant Island. There, the other blueberries were hiding in the clubhouse when Flick and Dot poked their heads inside.
Hello, kids. Ready to make some grasshoppers cry?
It's payback time, blueberry style. Oh, blueberries rock. Yay!
As Flick explained his plan to the blueberries, the circus bugs swung into action. Pretending to be the evening's entertainment, they interrupted a banquet being held by Hopper and his friends. First, Tuck and Roll performed a few acrobatics. Then the clowns came out. Finally, Manny launched into his magic act.
From the most mysterious regions of uncharted Asia, I give you the Chinese Cabinet of Metamorphosis. Utilizing psychic vibrations, I shall select the perfect volunteer. Aha! Why, Your Majesty!
He extended his hand to the Queen. She rose to her feet, and Manny led her over to Dim. She climbed over the giant beetle toward Manny's cabinet, then Dim walked off stage. The audience didn't know it, but instead of entering the cabinet, the queen had hidden behind Dim's wings, safe from the grasshoppers. Above them, Flick and the blueberries scrambled up the tree where the bird was stored. One by one, they jumped inside.
Blueberries ready?
Ready!
As dark clouds gathered overhead, Manny's magic act continued.
And now, Insectus Transformatus!
Manny's cabinet opened, and instead of the queen, Gypsy stepped out. She spread her wings, and the grasshoppers gasped.
Ooh, pretty.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Hopper was not amused. He looked around for the queen.
Where is she?
He motioned to his friends, and they closed in on the circus bugs. In the tree above them, Flick grinned at the blueberries and launched the bird.
Hold on!
Hopper looked up. his face contorted with fear. The bird swooped and dove, with Dot calling out instructions inside.
Up, down, and turn!
Nearby, in the circus wagon, P.T. Flea saw what was happening. He broke out of the wagon just before the bird went crashing into it, scattering matches everywhere. Thinking it was a real attack, P.T. picked up the matches, lit them, and flew toward the bird as Slim looked on.
Flaming dead!
No, P.T.!
The bird burst into flames. Inside, the blueberries tried to escape the smoke. Flick sprang into action, releasing the emergency lever.
Okay, everyone out! Hurry!
The blueberries filed out, with Dot at the end of the line. As she hurried after the others, Hopper grabbed her and turned to Ada.
Whose idea was this? Huh? Was it yours, Princess?
Flick stepped forward.
Leave her alone, Hopper! The bird was my idea. I'm the one you want.
Hopper released Dot. Then he snapped his fingers and Thumper pounced on Flick. The snarling grasshopper beat Flick mercilessly. Finally, Hopper called off Thumper and leaned over Flick's battered body.
You piece of dirt. No, I'm wrong. You're lower than dirt. You're an ant. Let this be a lesson to all you ants. Ideas are very dangerous things. You are mindless, soil-sucking losers. Put on this earth to serve us.
You're wrong, Hopper.
Amazingly, Flick had somehow pulled himself up to face the cruel grasshopper.
I've seen these ants do great things. And year after year, they somehow managed to pick food for themselves and you. So who is the weaker species? Ants don't serve grasshoppers. It's you who need us. We're a lot stronger than you say we are. And you know it, don't you?
Hopper raised a foot to crush Flick. But his brother Molt stopped him.
Hopper, I hate to interrupt, but
Hopper looked up and saw his worst nightmare coming true. Princess Ada and the entire ant colony had the grasshoppers surrounded.
You ants, get back!
You see, Hopper, nature has a certain order. The ants pick the food, the ants keep the food, and the grasshoppers leave.
With a loud roar, the ants charged the grasshoppers, who took off, screaming in terror.
Come back here, you cowards! Don't leave!
A swarm of ants lifted Hopper off the ground, and Flick led them to the circus cannon, where they stuffed Hopper inside.
Happy landings, Hopper!
Before they could fire the cannon, another explosion sounded. It was thunder. Giant raindrops crashed to the ground all around them, sending ants and circus bugs scattering. Hopper, seeing a chance to escape, grabbed Flick and raced up the side of the tree, dodging raindrops. Ada and the circus bugs followed. Hopper climbed higher and higher, then took off and hovered above the tree. Just as Hopper thought he was safe, a blur flew past. Pulling Flick from his clutches, it was Ada. She and Flick raced off, side by side.
Go that way!
But the ant hill's over!
I've got an idea!
They made their way to the creek bed, with Hopper hot on their trail. By now, the creek was no longer dry, and water cascaded all around them. Flick and Adam moved steadily forward through raindrops that exploded like mortar shells.
There! Come on! Gotta hide!
Flick pulled Ada up the bank and behind a rock.
No matter what happens, stay down!
Then he stepped out from behind the rock and into Hopper's path.
Flake, no! What are you doing?
Hopper!
You think it's over?
No, I can explain!
All your little stunt did was buy them time!
He grabbed Flick by the throat and started choking him.
No, please! Please, Hopper!
I'll get more grasshoppers and be back next season, but you won't.
Hopper looked up and saw what Flick had known all along. They were right below the sparrow's nest. As Hopper watched, the sparrow fluttered down toward them.
Well, what's this? Another one of your little bird tricks? Are there a bunch of little girls in this one, too? Hello, girl!
A look of shock crossed Hopper's face as he was lifted from the ground, causing him to release Flick. Ada pulled Flick to safety, and together they watched as the sparrow, gripping its prize, flew back to the nest and offered Hopper to its babies. Several days later, the circus bugs packed up their wagon and got ready to leave. Francis was surrounded by blueberries.
I'm not gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry.
P.T. called to a new member of the troupe.
Hey, Tiny! Let's get this show packed up. We got paying customers hatching.
Hopper's brother, Malt, stepped forward, carrying the cannon.
Yes, Mr. Flay. Yes, sir. Of course, sir. Right away, sir. And I just wanted to thank you for giving me a chance, because it's an honor to work with creative giants such as yourself.
P.T. turned to Flick, who stood beside Ada, holding her hand.
You sure you can't come on tour with us?
Sorry. My place is here.
I want to thank all of you for giving us back our hope, our dignity, and our lives.
And to you, Princess Atta, you have given us so much. Please accept this gift from us bugs to you ants.
For you.
Oh! It's a rock.
The circus bugs beamed, convinced they had given her the perfect gift. The queen, meanwhile, took the crown off her own head and placed it on Ada's.
All right, now it's getting mushy. We're out of here! Hi-yah!
As the wagon started forward, Dim lifted it high into the air, along with everyone on board. All the bugs were smiling, except for Francis.
We forgot Heimlich!
Far below, a cocoon jiggled from side to side, then popped open.
I'm finished! Finally, I'm a beautiful butterfly! My wings, oh, so beautiful!
Heimlich, who looked just the same except for a pair of tiny wings, struggled into the air with the help of Francis and Manny. He joined the other circus bugs on the wagon, and they waved to the ants.
Auf Wiedersehen!
Bye!
Thank you!
The ants watched the circus bugs disappear into the distance. Then they went back to work, this time using Flick's harvester invention.
Present stocks! Harvester, salute!
If you walked by, you probably wouldn't even notice them. But if you stopped and took a close look, you'd see them smiling, talking, working happily in the sun. They were free of the grasshoppers and, thanks to Flick and his friends, were looking forward to their best harvest ever. They called the place Ant Island, and it was bursting with life. A bug's life.